one of the biggest places for gaming news and upcoming stuff is E3, and I know a lot of people are wondering exactly what's going to be shown there. And of course, by now, you all know what E3 is all about. It basically is a place where you just learn about all the new upcoming games coming out. It's really a huge hype pot. Now, I want to give a big shout out to Luigi Smash for showing me this, but he linked me to an IGN article, which apparently is going to list some potential things that may be at E3 2015. And I think it's usually held in LA, right? If I'm correct. It's usually LA, right? So anyways, we're going to go to this article right now, and we're going to see exactly what this is. So, I haven't looked at this list yet, so I'm going to be finding out along with you guys to see exactly what E3 has coming up. So, games at E3 2015. The games at E3 2015 list contains all the suspected and confirmed games appearing at E3 2015 in some form, not necessarily in playable form. So, either way, I guess this list is more of like a speculation list, but considering it is IGN, it must be like an educated speculation list, just so, you know, they can potentially, like, you know, speculate on what's coming up. So let's take a look at this. So platform exclusive games are color-coded in the list below, so of course by the three big guys. Click on the game name to jump to the wiki or game info page for more information, trailers, and screenshots. The list contains both games likely to appear at E3 2015 that have been previously announced by a developer or publisher, and games that have been confirmed to appear. Confirmed games are noted in the first column by an asterisk. Only a handful of games have been confirmed for E3 as of yet, but likely games are listed below. So, like I said, this is basically going to be a list which shows us what most likely is going to show up. If it hasn't been released yet already, we already know what most of these games on this list are going to be, and Xenoblade Chronicles X is definitely going to be one of those titles. So let's take a look at this. So Assassin's Creed Victory, we already knew about this game, definitely coming up. It's definitely going to make a showing at E3, no problem at all, because, you know, that's what Ubisoft does, man. Every year they release a new Assassin's Creed now, so this is expected. Borderlands 3, okay, no, that'd be an interesting title to see. Crackdown, The Division, another big title, which was announced at, where was The Division announced? I think it was announced at last year's E3. Don't quote me on that one, though. Doom, okay, wow, okay, so a Doom game for Xbox One, PS4, and PC, okay. Fable Legends, Forza 6, Gears of War 4. This is gonna be interesting. Gears of War is a series, I played 1 and 2. I didn't get to play the third one, where it's like a prequel, but still, it's a great series. Really good gameplay, multiplayer aspect. Halo 5 Guardians, I never played a Halo game, although it does look interesting. Homefront 2, The Revolution, okay, Just Cause 3. Kingdom Hearts 3, we'll probably get that in 2017. Legend of Zelda for Wii U, very exciting looking title. Lego Jurassic World, Mad Max, Mario Maker, Mass Effect 4, Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. And you know, this is something that I've always wanted to get into, the Metal Gear Solid series, and I just never really had the time to sit down and play it until now. I'm probably going to be trying to get into Metal Gear Solid myself to catch up with the series, because it looks like it goes so deep, man, and it looks like the story in that is insane. There's a whole culture of people my age who were raised on Metal Gear Solid, so I kind of want to see where they're coming from. So that's a really big series I'm looking forward to playing. Minecraft Story Mode for Xbox One, Xbox 360, PS4, PS3, PC. Oh my god, it's coming up for pretty much everything but Nintendo stuff. Minecraft Story Mode. What the hell is this? What the hell is this? Minecraft Story Mode will be an all-new narrative-driven game series developed by Telltale Games in collaboration with Mojang. Oh, okay. Set in the world of Minecraft and features an original story driven by player choice, the episodic game series mixes new characters with familiar themes and an entirely original Minecraft experience inspired by the Minecraft community and the game community. Okay, so it's basically Minecraft with a story mode. Okay, simple enough. Let's see here. Let's see. Shin Megami Tensei and Fire Emblem. This is the big one right here. And, you know, I'm a fan of both of these series, actually. I only played the Devil Survivor series of the games, but, you know, those were amazing. And then I know Shin Megami Tensei is also involved with Persona. So these are definitely big titles. And the fact that they're crossing over like that, yeah, I can see why a lot of people are excited. Titanfall 2, that one. That one. I'm looking forward to that one because Titanfall was a great game. It just lacked a lot of what makes a first-person shooter full feeling, but Titanfall 2 should definitely make up for it. Let's see. Xenoblade Chronicles X, of course. Of course. Xenoblade Chronicles X was on this list, and IGN has confirmed with the publisher that this game will appear at E3 in some form, not necessarily playable, and we didn't really get something like that for Titanfall, did we? Well, Either way, Xenoblade Chronicles X is definitely something we're looking forward to. It's definitely going to be there. And so, yeah, what do you guys think of this list so far? What are you the most excited about? Mine is definitely Assassin's Creed Victory, The Division as well. Also looking forward to Legend of Zelda for Wii U. Even though I know I don't really seem like I'm that much of a Zelda fan, I do like the games. Kingdom Hearts 3 is also another one. The Minecraft thing, I don't know. Shin Megami Tensei and Fire Emblem, definitely those. And Titanfall 2, and last but not least, Xenoblade Chronicles X, Yoshi's Woolly World, I don't care about. But I mean, these are the games I'm excited for though. Let me know in the comments what you think about this list, and what new stuff do you think could possibly be pulled out at E3? I think they hit most of the big targets, but we'll see for ourselves, I suppose. I'll talk to you, oh, and maybe Final Fantasy 15, did they even list that? Okay, they didn't unlist that, so, they didn't list that, so, hey. We'll see what this list brings in the future. I'm sure they'll be updating it, and I'll be keeping on top of these. So, hey, I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Take care of yourselves, and of course, as usual, please have yourself a damn good one.